Today's devotional reading is James chapter 4, verses 1 to 17. That is James chapter 4, verses 1 to 17. As always, I remind you that it's important that you read the chapter for yourself. In my commentary, I will be focusing on verses 1 to 3, which says, "From whence cometh wars and fightings among you? Come they not hence, even of your lusts that war in your members? Ye lust and have not, ye kill and desire to have, and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because ye ask not. Ye ask and receive not, because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume it upon your lusts." Let me comment briefly on winning on the inside in order to enjoy peace on the outside. Winning on the inside in order to enjoy peace on the outside. Carnality and lust are a torment to a child of God, that is, a born-again Christian. When a believer indulges in them, they war against his peace, his progress, his relationship, and his victory in the Lord. In fact, the Apostle Peter did hit the nail on the head in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 11, when he said, "Beloved, I beg you as sojourners and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts which war against the soul." As a pastor, I have come across some believers who are ever at war with other believers. Almost everyone offends them. They find fault with the pastor, with the message that is preached, with the choir. They find fault with this brother, with that sister, etc. They hardly can function well in any activity group because other people are always offending them. They hardly can maintain a cordial relationship for long before the other person becomes the point of offense. Often, they skip church services and prefer to stay at home because they don't want to be offended by other church members. They complain about almost everybody, and before you know it, they are changing or thinking of changing church. The only person they do not find problem with is themselves, and yet the problem is right within them. When almost anyone you come across or interact with is a bad person, chances are that the problem is with you. Did you hear that? When almost anyone you come across or interact with is a bad person, chances are that the problem is with you. The lust and the carnality within is what causes the restlessness, the fightings, and the finger pointing, and that is what James is telling us in this chapter. Life in Christ has no provision for carnality and lustful indulgences, and if you fail to deal with them, they will vex your soul and cause you a lot of trouble. Unfortunately, quite often, those involved do not realize that the problem they are having with other people have their roots in their own carnality and worldliness. And quite often, the devil is blamed for the strife and misunderstanding amongst God's people. But what we should not forget is that he merely takes advantage of the doors that believers open to him. So we must learn to deal with the loss on the inside of us. We must learn to have victory, walk in victory. When we are at peace with ourselves and we are at peace with God, when we keep the flesh under control, then it is very easy for us to enjoy peace on the outside. We wouldn't come into a situation where we are so touchy and everyone around us is seen as a bad person. When it is like that, take a look inside, because you need to learn to win on the inside if you want to enjoy peace on the outside, either with yourself or with other people. What is the solution to this problem? There are three solutions given to us in this chapter. The first is to humble ourselves before God. It is humility to acknowledge that we are not living right and that there is carnality in our lives. The second is a true-hearted repentance accompanied with a godly sorrow, like we see in verses 8 and 9. Where conviction and repentance are that deep, we won't find ourselves returning to the same thing soon after. And thirdly, we must fully surrender our lives to God. That means we've got to desire to please Him by putting away what He hates and allow Him to take full control of our lives. By doing these three things, I believe that we begin to enjoy victory on the inside and enjoy peace on the outside as we relate with other people. So that is it for today, beloved. Until I come your way again tomorrow, this Pastor Vincent saying to you, bye for now.